Hi, I'm Stephen Jeske. In this MarketMuse Academy video, we're going to use MarketMuse to help us write a product review for the Rode Procaster. Like the previous video, we'll be putting all the applications to work. So first we need to decide on the topic. In this case, we'll use Rode Procaster review as our topic. Keep in mind that we're creating content just using these applications. Since we're not taking advantage of a content brief, it won't have the same nuanced topic model. In the case of a content brief, each section has its own topic model, along with the questions to answer and linking suggestions. But what we're doing here is applying just one topic model to the entire piece of content, so keep that limitation in mind. Now, typically, you'll want consistency in the structure of your reviews from one to the next. For microphones, it could be something like this: sound quality, cost, performance, pros and cons. I've picked these as subheadings because I believe they are the main areas of concern for potential buyers. So first, let's get them into Optimize. If you prefer, you could build the article in your favorite text editor and then copy and paste it into Optimize to check that it meets the target content score and word count. Now, you may notice that I've elaborated a little bit on those subheadings. For example, I'm not just using sound quality. I'm writing sound quality of the Rode Procaster microphone. And instead of cost, I'm using Rode Procaster cost. For performance, I'm using Procaster microphone performance. And for pros and cons, it's pros and cons of this Rode microphone. I've done that for the benefit of search engines, making it easier for them to connect these subheadings. If I was writing strictly for humans, this step wouldn't really be necessary. I could just stick to the original subheadings of sound quality, cost, performance, pros and cons. Now, we are writing for humans as well, and so I don't want to repeat Rode Procaster in each subheading. So instead, I've used some related terms from the topic model, and they are the ones that are highlighted in green. Next, we want to make sure we address all the important questions that people are asking when looking at reviews of the Rode Procaster. For that, we'll turn to the questions application. We'll go down the list and add the relevant questions to various sections in the article. Now let's take a look at the heat map in Compete, where we can differentiate our content. The heat map maps the content in the top 20 of the search engine results page to the topic model. The first thing that grabs my attention is the topic USB microphone. All those red squares tell me that few people discuss this topic, and a quick Google search reveals that this mic has an XLR output, meaning it's not a USB microphone. But many people may not understand that you can't plug a mic with an XLR output directly into your computer USB port, so this is definitely something to mention. Plus, it's a topic that warrants its own page, which we could link to in this review as well, so I want to make a note of that somewhere, either by adding to a plan or within MarketMuse or wherever. While looking at Compete, I'm also on the lookout for table stake topics. Those are the ones that everyone is covering and that I should too. For example, nearly everyone mentions that this is a dynamic microphone, so it's something I'll need to include in my review. Background noise is another topic that needs to be addressed, although only about half of the top 20 in the SERP cover this. I think it's an important factor in sound quality anyway. Sure, SM7B is another microphone that frequently comes up when discussing the Rode Procaster, so I'll probably want to draw some comparisons as I discuss sound quality, price, etc. This is also a good signal that a full article comparing both products head-to-head would be quite valuable to create. Now, the Shure SM58 only gets mentioned once, so I'm going to want to investigate that a little more and see if there's much demand for that. So I'm just going to continue going through all the topics and Compete and copy some of them over into Optimize. Of course, I could just stay within Optimize, but in this case, I want to understand what I need to cover and what I can do to stand out from the crowded review space. I also want to look at Connect to determine what links may be appropriate. One of the challenges in this particular case is that many of the links themselves are product reviews. However, the anchor text suggestions, which are based on the topic model, are highly related to the subject. So I want to keep some of them and substitute other links. Since I'm not doing that right now, I'll just make a note of it. And there you have it. Our outline is set. Looking at our content score, we've done a good job at covering the subject. But keep in mind, this is just an outline. We still need to create an engaging narrative that flows nicely covering all these points, but at least to get the idea. In the next video, we'll look at how to optimize an existing piece of content.